It's Lynda Cromar. I'm coming to you from my home office in Colorado, and I'm doing this a little later than I generally do. But I needed to get something off my chest, and that is, there is so much of the time that I see people that are always just throwing their links all over the place, and the problem is that that does not create a sale. And you're actually skipping a step, because before there is a team member or a sale, there is a lead, and that lead comes from somewhere. Now, yes, it can come right here from Facebook, but you've got to realize that the majority of the people you're probably in connection with are not actually looking to buy anything, because Facebook isn't intended to be a place where you buy. So it's not an actual marketplace, although it can be if you do it right. But what really works better is to find ways to solve their problem. Now, what is their problem? You have to know what your product solves. Mine, it solves that initial problem of, yes, I want a sale, but first I must have a lead. I must have a lead that targets to that product and wants what I have to offer. So my job is not to sell to that person until they actually discover that I might have their solution. Now, I know that sounds different than what you probably hear most of the time. Just keep battering people over the head and eventually they'll buy? No. If you've ever been to a car lot where you have a particularly aggressive salesman, think about that for a minute. What is your initial desire when they start practically preying on you to get that sale and talking to you and harassing you almost until you get to a point where, what is it, your desire at that point? Is it to buy? No. Your desire is to leave, is to run, get in your car and get out of there, because you're not comfortable with somebody doing that. And the same thing is happening on Facebook. The more you badger people for what you think they want, and you don't even know, because you're just offering it to them before you even find out if they have a problem you can solve. Hello. First, find out what the problem is. Then you give them an opportunity to learn about it. In other words, you give them a place where they can learn about it. And that means you give them an opportunity to opt in to your list. That makes them become a lead. That's the first step in the funnel. And a lot of people are trying to go from the bottom. You know, here's the top where the lead comes in, and everybody's trying to do down here before the lead is in. You can't do it that way. That's the surest way to make them be like, I'm out of here, just like that you would be if you had a very aggressive salesman trying to convince you to buy before you're ready to buy. And Facebook is not a place where that happens. And actually, most social media isn't. They have to become a lead. In other words, they have to show an interest in what you have because they're thinking it could solve their problem. And that is one of the things I took a long time to learn, but it is a very important lesson. When you have your pages that are really buy links, and that's all you're offering, you know, to your network marketing, your MLM, your affiliate program, your direct sales, whatever it is, if you're not actually getting them in the funnel, basically starting the process from the beginning, then you are missing the boat big time. And that is why you're struggling and not getting any sales at all. You want to create real sales. And the real sales don't come until the person sees what you have and says, oh, that is what I've been looking for. Maybe it wasn't actually, but maybe they start to see that it could actually solve their problem. Now, if you're talking to somebody that eats chips all day and never thinks about their health, and you're trying to give them a health and wellness link, you're missing the boat. That isn't your target market, even if they are overweight, and generally they are. The hard part is they haven't come to the conclusion that they have a problem to solve, or they don't think they can solve it with what you are offering. They have to become a lead in baby steps. In other words, what small problem could you possibly solve first before they're going to maybe get a little deeper and decide, maybe I need to eat a little more healthy? But they aren't going to come to that conclusion at the beginning if they've got bad habits about how they eat. I know myself, I have some bad habits. That's why I've got some overweight. I'm not fat to the point where I look awful, but I have a big belly I need to get rid of. But I have to come to the conclusion that your health problem, your health product will actually solve that problem before I'm going to say yes. And so first I might need to see something for free. That's what I do most of the time. I have free, you can get in on everything I'm doing right now for free, have a chance to look at it. Then you can decide whether or not it will actually suit you and help you. And when somebody says, hey, this does look like it solves my problem, then they take the big bite and they buy. They don't do it at the beginning. And that's been one of the really biggest and worst problems, especially in network marketing companies. They immediately try to convince you to start sharing your product immediately before they even start to see that it could possibly be a solution to their problem. So number one, they have to see that they have a problem. Number two, they have to actually come in from the beginning as a lead. Maybe you have something you can offer for free. So much of the time, people don't. They think that they need to get the big sale right away, and they're missing the boat because you won't get the big sale before you get the lead. And once you get the lead, you start to warm them up and show them what you can share and maybe give them some good tips that they can use, regardless of whether they buy or not. Let them come in free, and eventually they will upgrade themselves. And that's called soft sell. You don't have to do the hard sell like the salesman that you want to get away with, get away from as quickly as possible. Don't be that guy that is beating them over the head by throwing your link everywhere all the time. In fact, Facebook doesn't let me put links up, so I think it's getting to the point where it's going to be the case for everybody. It's going to be harder and harder to share your links. And it's going to need a little more creativity on your part to continue to sell your product. Instead of just thinking, I've got to sell my product today, let's start thinking about what kind of ways can I bring that person to me as a lead first for something free that might solve their problem. Let them have a chance to look at it. Let them have a chance to learn a little bit. And maybe get to a more committed level, then they will get to a place where they're saying, hey, I think that will solve my problem. I'm ready to buy. And you know what? They sold themselves. And that's the very best way to do it. I like that way because I'm not one that likes to beat people over the head with my links or convincing them or doing a chat message where you tell them all about it before you even say hi. Those kind of methods don't work these days. People are too wise to it. So instead, let's look at ways they can become leads. And I have solutions for that. Let's talk. And if you found this of any kind of value, please like, comment, and share. And I'll be talking with you again tomorrow. Bye for now.